Welcome to the Discovery Center of Idaho and our Tinker the T.rex virtual school program, Tinkering with Tinker. Thank you for sharing your time with us today. So, what is the Discovery Center of Idaho? The Discovery Center of Idaho is a science center located in Boise, Idaho, and a science center is a type of museum. What is a museum, you ask? Museums are spaces that tell stories about people, places, and things using objects or images. The stories we tell as a science center focus on how we understand the world around us, people, places, and things, through science, technology, engineering, and math. You've probably all heard the acronym STEM, but sometimes STEM is used so much that we forget that these areas of study all have different definitions and goals, even though they very often work together. Let's go through a quick reminder of what each part means before we jump into the meat of today's presentation. So, science is how we learn and understand the world around us by asking questions, observing, and experimenting. Technology is using science and engineering to make products and processes that make life better. Engineering is applying what we learn and understand about the world around us to solve problems or to make things. And math is simply the study of numbers, shapes, and patterns. So remember how I said that museums tell stories about people, places, and things using objects and images? Well, have we got a story to tell you? Before I introduce you formally to my friend Tinker, we're going to create some common ground of scientific knowledge surrounding dinosaurs to explore the story that fossils, like Tinker's, are telling. I bet most of you know way more than I do, so these should be super easy questions for you to answer. First of all, what is a fossil? Is a fossil a skeleton of a plant or animal from ancient times? Are fossils rocks created from imprints left behind by skeletons? Or are they left behind pieces of living things preserved in the earth? What do you think? You can talk to your neighbor about this, or maybe talk as a class about what you think a fossil is. Is it A, B, or C? Well, the answer is not bones. Let's remember that everything is made out of matter. And we all know that all matter decays or falls apart over time. Skeletons and bones actually decay rather quickly in geological time. So it would be impossible for an actual bone to still be intact from millions and millions of years ago. However, we do have fossils. Fossils are rock created from imprints left behind by skeletons and filled in by minerals over time, and also left behind pieces of living things preserved in the earth or amber, like prehistoric bugs trapped in amber. Tinker is a cast. So Tinker isn't actual fossils. Rather, the paleontologist created molds out of the rock fossils, kind of like ice trays, of Tinker's bones, and then filled those molds with material to recreate the shape of the bones so that we can put them together with bolts and screws and share their stories. Okay, so let's move on. Next question. When did dinosaurs like the T-Rex live? The Triassic period, the Jurassic period, or the Cretaceous period? Hey, here's another chance for you to pause the video and see what your classmates think. How many of you think it's Triassic? And how many of you think it's B, Jurassic period? And how many of you think it's the Cretaceous period? Are you ready for the answer? You were all correct, all before humans even existed. Geologists or scientists who study rocks and minerals divide the history of the Earth into long chunks of time called eras. Each era is marked by changes in the fossils found in the rock layers. The Mesozoic era is known as the Age of Dinosaurs. Within this era, shorter periods are marked by different kinds of dinosaurs and other prehistoric animals. Tinker and other Tyrannosaurus thrived in the late Cretaceous period, just before the dinosaurs went extinct. The climate then was very hot and wet, and jungles and flowering plants covered much of North America. Okay, last question. What kind of scientist studies dinosaurs? Is it an archaeologist, a paleontologist, or a podiatrist? Are you guys ready? Do you have your answer? Okay. It's a paleontologist. A paleontologist is a scientist who studies the history of life on Earth through the fossil record. Remember, fossils are the evidence of past life on the planet and can include those formed from animal bodies or their imprints. Some of you might have thought the answer was archaeologist. Well, archaeologists and paleontologists are very similar, but archaeologists focus on learning the human stories of the past, and paleontologists focused on ancient Earth, focusing on the fossil record before humans got here. If you chose C, podiatrist, you're funny. A podiatrist is a doctor who specializes in fixing foot problems. Now that we've got our bases covered, let's move on to the meat of today's program. I'd like to introduce you to my friend, Tinker. Tinker is the nickname of a young Tyrannosaurus rex, that means tyrant lizard king, that was found near Belle Fourche, South Dakota in the U.S. Tinker is roughly two-thirds or 70% the size of a full-sized T-Rex and dates from about 70 to 66 million years ago during the late Cretaceous period. This theropod, or a carnivorous three-toed dinosaur, was an adolescent when it died. Tinker wasn't a little kid, but also wasn't fully grown yet when they died, so we refer to Tinker as an adolescent. Try this. Stand next to your parent or your teacher. Are you the same height? Are you shorter? Think of friends or family members who were considered preteens or teens. They're usually about 70% the size of their parents. So that's about the same as Tinker to their parents. Tinker was about 20 feet long and may have weighed 1,200 pounds. This is about two-thirds the size of an adult T-Rex, but only about one-quarter of an adult's weight. Huh. So let's do the math. If 1,200 pounds is one-quarter of an adult's weight, then if we multiply 1,200 pounds by 4, then we would get to the average adult weight. So 4 times 1,200, 4 times 12 is 48, so 4 times 1,200 would be 4,800 pounds, or in other words, over 2 tons. Whew, that's heavier than most cars. So what stories can Tinker's fossils tell us? Everything we see can tell a story, whether it's in the clothes you're wearing, a piece of art, or a dinosaur fossil. So let's start by looking closely at Tinker in this video. There they are. And we're going to look really closely and ask ourselves what we see. Well, gosh, as we look, I see lots of little divots or imprints or dimples all over. And I see some scratches. Maybe that has to do with where the tendons and the joints were connected. I see a jaw. I see a weird hole there. Kind of looks like a Pac-Man eye. I wonder what that is. Is that his eye? Is that, or okay, so now I'm starting to see more bones, and I'm seeing what look like maybe rib bones and a backbone. And oh my goodness, there's the little arms that we all know about T-Rex. And so let's look at that in comparison with all the bigness of everything else. It makes me really wonder. And I see some really interesting, we're going to have to look at that different because some of those ribs have big chunks on them and other ribs are smooth. So I wonder what that's about. And oh, I see how this is a cast. And so because it's held together by these rods here to hold it up so that we can learn from it. Okay, what else do I see here? I see a lot of scratches, and I'm wondering what those scratches might be. I see how the bones all connect together, and I see how here the tail looks just like a long spine. And as we just keep looking, what else do you guys see? Do you see you know, how it starts to taper or get smaller and smaller? I wonder how the size of that tail affects how T. Tinker moves. Oh, look how tiny it gets at the end. That's incredible. There's so many cool questions just by looking closely. And here we can also see that there's a full-sized T-Rex head there to compare with the size of Tinker's head down at the other end. Oh, so many cool things to be able to look at. What are some of the things that you noticed? Why don't you talk as a class and see what you noticed? One of the things that I noticed that I thought was super interesting were these bumps on the ribs. Do you see those there? So on the ribs, sometimes we can find these things in this. It's called calcification. So has anyone broken their arm or maybe broken their leg or something like that? And after you broke a bone, you had to put it in a cast. And then once it healed, your arm looked perfectly fine and everything was good. Well, what happens when you break your arm and you don't get to put it in a cast, or you break a bone and you don't sit still and let it heal on its own, is that the bone itself calcifies. So it starts to create more calcium and more minerals around it to heal itself than sometimes it needs. And so it makes kind of this bumpy look on the bone. And so what we can tell by looking at that, the story that we can see by looking closely at those ribs, is that Tinker must have broken their ribs at some point, whether in a fight or maybe they fell down. We don't know how they broke their ribs, but we know that that is not how Tinker died, because if Tinker died that way, the bones wouldn't have had time to heal themselves, because it takes a long time to heal. If you've ever broken your arm, you know you have to have that cast on your arm for a long time before it heals. So we know that these happened sometime during Tinker's life, and that they healed while Tinker was still alive, and that Tinker died in a different way, not by these broken bones. So there's lots of cool stories we can learn just by looking closely at the fossils and the bone record that we have in front of us. So let's move on to another cool thing we can learn by looking closely at fossils. So here is a video that we created. We printed a 3D model of Tinker that showcases how her tail keeps her balanced. So how does Tinker's balance change when we move the tail from side to side? Let's see. Whoa. Oh my, that doesn't look good. Let's see what happens when we move it the other way. Whoa. Still not quite working right. What happens when the tail is like that? Look at that. It creates a balance. So what's happening there? Tinker's long pointed tail helps to counterbalance the massive head. The dinosaur's body pivoted at the hip, just like a giant seesaw. The tail also helped balance swift turns, which was important for a meat eater tracking prey. So let's look at that one more time, thinking about those things we just learned, and see how the tail turned in a different way is going to counteract the balance of the T-Rex. It might help it turn, it might help it move things. It doesn't mean that the tail was always in one particular place, but it did help to act as a counterbalance. So here's a fun fact. Scientists once believed that T-Rex stood upright with its tail dragging along the ground like a kangaroo. Today, we know this posture would not have been possible because the dinosaur's heavy weight would have crushed its joints. We're always learning something new in science.
So have you ever bit your tongue or your lip or the insides of your cheeks while you're eating? Oh, ouch, right? Watch as I bite this almond. Wow, I annihilated it with very little effort and with pretty flat teeth. So when we chew, we're exerting lots of force or pounds of pressure with our teeth to tear through our food. Now these rods measure pounds of pressure. Let's see how much pounds of pressure I can exert with my puny little human muscles. Are you ready? Oh my goodness. Oh wow, so strong, 82 pounds of pressure. That's so awesome. Okay, so now I'm going to introduce you to my little friend, Minnie Tinker. Hello! And we're going to pretend like this pretzel right up here is the bone of a large herbivore. Now, we know that I'm only able to create about 82 pounds of pressure. So let's see what 82 pounds of pressure plus super sharp teeth does to this pretzel. Are you ready? I hope this works. Wow! Yikes! So imagine an adult T-Rex with 60 saw-edged or serrated teeth biting down with 10,000 pounds of pressure. This is the strongest of any land animal we've ever known. And here's another reason to run when you hear a T-Rex. When the T-Rex lost his teeth, they just grew new ones to replace them.
Speaking of running away, thankfully, Tinker and Tinker's parents probably didn't run very fast. And humans could outrun them in a race. Well, maybe if you're an Olympian. But how do we know how fast he ran? We learned that from imprint fossils. We can measure the depth and distance between footprints in the fossil record to determine how fast something might have moved. Isn't that cool how you can use math in that super specific way? So, what's so special about Tinker? So the fact that Tinker has the same teeth as an adult T-Rex, plus the fact that there is no indication of Tinker having had different baby teeth, tells us a lot. He must have eaten the same food as the adults. There were some acid-eroded and etched duckbill remains mixed with Tinker's bones. This indicated that might have been his last meal. It would have been a meal identical to what his parents would have eaten. Why is this significant, or why is this important? Well, this is significant because to learn about things from long ago with very little physical evidence, sometimes scientists look at similar living things around today and consider whether there might be similarities. For example, baby crocodiles have totally different teeth than adult crocodiles. The baby teeth are needle sharp for snagging insects, frogs, and other small prey. Their parents don't feed on those. They look for food and large prey on their own that require much stronger teeth. So when Nanotyrannus, a smaller theropod about half the size of a Tyrannosaurus, was first discovered, many scientists insisted it was a young T-Rex. Nanoteeth are sharper and more delicate than Rex teeth, similar to baby crocodiles. So it seemed reasonable to suggest that maybe the T-Rex grew similarly to a crocodile. Finding Tinker helped to sort out that theory. Tinker's teeth are every bit T-Rex, not at all like nanoteeth. It is possible that Tinker could have begun to hunt for himself, but he was pretty young. Mammalian predators today, at Tinker's age, don't hunt. Rather, they feed on the food caught by their parents. So were Tyrannosaurus more like modern lions or leopards than modern crocodiles? We don't know for sure. But finds like Tinker might help us answer these questions and many more. So thank you so much for sharing your time with us today. We hope that you have been inspired to learn more about dinosaurs and maybe even how to become a paleontologist. The exhibition Tinker the T-Rex is on display at the Discovery Center of Idaho throughout this school year. Grab your parents or grandparents or friends or neighbors and tell them all about the amazing things you've learned today. We hope you can visit Tinker. If you have any questions, you can contact us at education@dcidaho.org.